The unfortunate 96 people who went to a football match and didn't come back.
Just a football match. Come on.
Thanks.
And if anybody wants a photograph after, it's £1.50 each. If anyone wants to get any photographs,
Absolutely.
The beauty is, you know, Frank, I keep insisting, I'm not a Lord man,
I'm a Lord man.
Liverpool is better than most other places, so we have a lot of them. But, I think the position of a Lord Mayor in Liverpool is different to the Mayor as such in other places. The Mayor has total power. Somebody described it this morning as meeting some mayors in China, and he said, and they've got the power of life and death. I don't know what you do here, but I don't do much about it. But it is that the mayor has he makes the decisions that affect the citizens in England, because we have the political system and the leader of the council makes the important decisions. And technically, the Lord Mayor has a titular position who stands around trying to look useful, sounding intelligent. But his basic job is to actually meet and greet people and tell them about the city. And having said that, it is to attract investment. So it's to have a knowledge of the city, to tell people what goes on and get people to come back, whether it be business people, visitors, dignitaries, guests, anybody who comes here, just to make the stay a bit pleasant and entertaining. So I'll be dancing for the entertainment. I don't dance very well. It's to actually make it interesting and answer any questions or queries. The main position for the Lord Mayor is actually to chair the City Council. So when you become Lord Mayor, to keep an independence and to become apolitical, you take it off everything. You come off all the committees. And technically, you have no input into any of the decisions that the council makes in the 12 months that you're Lord Mayor. But the reality is that you do have a lot of persuasive powers in the background of talking to officers and talking to people, telling them problems you've picked up and how you think it might be. And sometimes, if you do it the right way, you're actually very successful in getting things changed. But realistically, the chairing the council meetings and keeping them in order, we all know what politicians are like, it can be very difficult to keep struggling in order, especially when you keep putting a hand up saying, you haven't picked me yet, you haven't scored me. But yeah, it is keeping the business moving, keeping everything in order, so that we've got a full record, proper, clear way of going forward. But it involves everything, the Lord Mayor's post, as I say, meeting visitors in the town hall. Last night, although we had the Labour Party conference in Liverpool, and I'm a member of the Labour Party, I haven't been able to get to any of them because we've got that many meetings on as Lord Mayor. Last night we were up in Manchester, which is a little village just outside, just up the East Lancs Road there somewhere. And we do visit them now and again to make sure that they're all right. But the Consul General from China is actually leaving at the end of the month. And so they were having a bit of a get-together for them. But it was also the 62nd anniversary of the People's Republic of China. So it was an amazing event for them on two points. And even though the Labour Party was in Liverpool, it would have been untoward and certainly not dignified for us not to have been represented. So I actually got my passport stamped and went up the East Lancs Road and visited them. But it is all about keeping that international relationships going as well. For me, my past sins, I was a leader of the Labour Group and leader of the Council for 2 years. In 1996 to 1998, I was deputy leader for 2 years prior to that, and then leader of the council for 2 years. So I've had a bit of an experience on both sides, making the decisions and being Lord Mayor this year. There is a lot of difference because as leader of the council, you get the blame for everything. As Lord Mayor of the council, you get the praise for everything. So you turn up, a chauffeur takes you there, you sit down, you have a meal, and everyone's nice to you. And then they take you home, and they're all very pleased to have seen you. It's wonderful, honestly. And they reckon it's the fastest 12 months of your life because you go to that many places that you actually do it for 12 months for exactly that reason. You're out from early, it was out at 8 o'clock this morning, I'll be out till about 11 o'clock tonight. You're back out, I was out till late last night early. It's a very fast and interesting thing. And it's made much more interesting by the fact that quite often you go somewhere where they say, no speeches, no information, and as soon as you arrive, they say, can you give us a 10-minute speech? And you suddenly have to put it all together and sound as if you know what you're talking about. I haven't failed on many occasions yet. So, but it is, if people like to see the change. They like, especially in Liverpool, we have hundreds of community groups, and the community groups have various meetings and events and functions, and they like you to turn up at the functions just so that the ordinary people that just can get to know you. And you'll find this town hall a magnificent place, but it will be like places in your cities and in your countries. Many of the ordinary people have never been in there. So we actually encourage people to come in and have a look around and show that the Lord Mayor has two hands, two legs and one head. Because people, you know, they see the title and they think it's something totally different. I was very fortunate in being Lord Mayor this year because you actually do 12 months of Deputy Lord Mayor. Liverpool has a system whereby some cities don't work, not all cities work at the same. Some cities make